Your cause is the key to your healing. If you have been diagnosed with kidney disease, an essential part of this process is to determine the cause of kidney damage. When the cause of kidney damage is ascertained, and then treated, it helps to protect the kidneys from any future damage. Treating the kidneys but not curing the cause will only have a limited effect, as it is more than likely that the damage will simply be repeated over time. High blood pressure. High blood pressure is the second most common cause of chronic kidney disease, and is responsible for more than 26% of cases. High blood pressure has several causes, and while there is a strong genetic link, high blood pressure is linked to stress, poor diet, sedentary lifestyle, heavy metal toxicity, for example mercury or lead, and obesity. All of these are issues that need to be addressed for your general health, but become even more of a concern when they are linked to kidney disease. Because blood pressure can rise transiently, it requires 3 high readings in a row to establish high blood pressure. If you have a repeated reading of equal to or higher than 140/90, then your blood pressure needs to be addressed for the safety of your kidneys. Don't let it make matters worse. Let's take a look at how the cardiovascular system affects kidney function. It is actually quite simple to see how high blood pressure can burden the kidneys, because the kidneys perform their function by filtering blood through their tiny blood vessels. If your blood pressure is constantly high, this will mean that your blood is forced through your body and the tiny blood vessels in your kidneys continually, without relent. This constant, long-term high blood pressure will increase the pressure at which the kidneys are required to filter, forcing them to work harder and harder. Over time, this will exhaust your kidneys and their function will begin to diminish. Using natural therapies to reduce blood pressure will not only reduce your cardiovascular health risks, but it will also take the load off your kidneys and give them much needed energy to heal and perform their essential functions. As you can start to see, the solution is not always treating the kidneys first. Adequate attention to the cause is the cornerstone of great kidney and whole body health. Some simple dietary and lifestyle changes can help keep high blood pressure at bay, but initially, to get a quick response, you might want to combine some herbs and nutrients that help reduce blood pressure. The herb of choice when it comes to treating high blood pressure and protecting the cardiovascular system is hawthorn. But there are also other herbs that lower blood pressure and improve kidney function at the same time. For example, the herb danshen protects the kidneys and heart while lowering blood pressure. However, it does also thin the blood, so you need to avoid this herb if you are taking any pharmaceutical drugs that also cause blood thinning. For example, aspirin and warfarin. Interesting note. Both of these drugs, aspirin and warfarin, are based on naturally occurring chemicals in plants. In fact, it is estimated 30% of all drugs are based on naturally occurring chemicals in plants. Makes you wonder why some of the medical profession still has it in for natural therapies. I wonder if they know what they are really prescribing to their patients? That is plant medicine. Many remedies, for example magnesium, also help to reduce stress while working physiologically on the cardiovascular system, so they have multiple benefits. Some simple lifestyle changes can be very beneficial in regard to reducing both stress on the body and high blood pressure. The best place to start is to avoid smoking, alcohol and caffeine, and to participate in regular cardiovascular exercise. For example, swimming, brisk walking, aerobic classes, jogging or sports. The best diet for maintaining healthy blood pressure contains fresh and vital foods that will also support your kidney function and health in general. The simplest measures include avoiding high salt and high sugar foods, and also foods high in saturated fat, such as animal products and baked goods. At the same time, you should increase foods that are high in essential fatty acids, such as fish, and fresh vegetables and fruits that are high in magnesium and vitamin C. Normally, those with high blood pressure are told to increase potassium intake, but because potassium can be a problem for those with kidney disease, you will also find a lot of information saying to avoid it. What to do? I myself recommend that potassium levels need to be reduced and not avoided. Potassium is still a very important nutrient for the body, so please make sure you reduce and monitor it.
There are many natural therapies available. Combined with appropriate dietary and lifestyle changes, you can both reverse kidney damage and protect from further damage to your kidneys in the future. Get an effective step-by-step program proven to start healing your kidneys today by Duncan Cappuciano, ND, a fully qualified naturopath, author, and medical researcher specializing in kidney disease. Take action by clicking the link below. You'd be surprised how well this works.
If you're ready to take action, click on the link below this video now.